This is a companion video to my Free for Friday on banned films in the UK. Back in Action nearly made the cut, but I covered mediocre action film Kickboxer 4 The Aggressor instead. Back in Action was banned alongside Kickboxer 4, a VHS tape, in 1994. It has since had an uncut UK DVD release, which is said to be re-edited. Back in Action features Billy Blanks, who is a black belt in multiple martial arts. He is best known for his Taibo series, which is a fitness program combining martial arts moves, and was a huge success because it was a workout video that appealed to men. Before that, the only workout video chaps wanted to see starred Tracy Lords. It also stars Rowdy Roddy Piper, who is no longer with us. He was best known as a WWF wrestler who had a gift for trash talk and delivering witty monologues, with the athletic skills to back up his mouth. Unlike Hulk Hogan, who appeared in largely kid-friendly movies that were shit, Piper appeared in cult movies either by accident or design. They Live, his best-known film, is an Orwellian nightmare set in modern-day New York and is a legitimately great movie and a bona fide cult classic. Hell Comes to Frogtown is smack-bang mediocre, but a fun and delirious popcorn and six-pack party movie. Back in Action has a fairly typical plot. Billy Blanks is a former Green Beret who is protecting his sister from her gangster boyfriend. Then you have Roddy Piper as a cop trying to arrest the criminal gang. The two team up after a series of hilarious but brilliant fights. I didn't get much chemistry between the two for what is almost a buddy cop film. Don't get me wrong, both actors are charismatic, but you don't get the same tension you get with Mel Gibson and Danny Glover in Lethal Weapon or the buddy-buddy relationship of Bad Boys. Back in Action is B-movie, and it does look and feel like B-movie. From what I can tell, it had a limited theatrical release and did most of its sales on VHS and rentals. As a comparison, it's not as cheap looking as 1991 Tracy Lords vehicle, A Time to Die. But more importantly, Back in Action delivers where it counts. The action. You want to see 20 goons get mowed down with one rifle clip? You've got it. Where it shines are the fight scenes, as well as being nicely choreographed. Both leads get to show off their moves. Billy Blanks demonstrates his hard kicking style, and Rowdy Roddy Piper gets the chance to do many wrestling throws. The action scenes might not be as spectacular as those in Hollywood movies of the time like True Lies and In the Line of Fire, but you more than get your blockbuster rental money's worth. So why was a benign, albeit violent film, banned in 1994? Well, you have to take in account the BBFC's obvious bias towards lower budget indie films. The Gestapo's Last Orgy was refused a certificate in 2021 for the 88 films Blu-ray release, but equally shocking films that are more competently made, like Sallow and Antichrist, are both uncut and readily available in the UK. Then you have the climate at the time in the early 90s, the overhang of the video nasties panic of the 80s still being a concern under James Furman. It's unbelievable now to think you couldn't see Texas Chainsaw Massacre or its sequels without resorting to buying bootlegs or rare film screenings in the early 90s. Then you had the perfect storm of the tragic and shocking James Bulger murder that was linked to Child's Play 3, and the Hungerford Massacre of 1987, which was linked to John Rambo films. And in the USA, you had reported copycat killings linked to Natural Born Killers, which delayed the film being released up until 1996 in the UK, and then the VHS tape was withdrawn because of a Dunblane massacre. And finally, people in the UK got to legally see a copy of Natural Born Killers in 2001. Yep, it was that late. These films are all tenuously linked to violent films of the time and served as an easy scapegoat rather than asking the difficult questions as to why young people kill. Back in Action is undoubtedly violent and about on par with something like Menace to Society or Commando in terms of violence. It's mainly martial arts moves like ear claps, throat chops, kicks to the neck, headbutts, and even ear biting that the BBFC were concerned about, as they thought teenagers would imitate them. To be fair, we've all cut up a broom handle and attached a bike chain to it and pretended to be Bruce Lee with our own custom-made nunchucks. That often resulted in them swinging back and hitting us in the face. How many of us have done a Mike Tyson though and bitten off somebody's ear? The film eventually passed for VHS tape in 1994 with a stonking 9 minutes of cuts, missing out all of the most violent martial arts moves, like the ones previously mentioned. It did, however, pass uncut for DVD, but it is quite expensive and difficult to find. It's not a classic on the level of Predator, Cobra, or Die Hard, all films I saw when I was arguably too young to see them. They didn't affect me, other than fueling my love for high-octane, steroid-pumping action films.
I hate that cruddy shit. Now, you're under arrest for insulting an officer with that crap. Now, get your fat ass up now!